Welcome back, friends, to episode 2, Roads to Top 10. I got another team that I built and tested. This is actually the third version of the team, if I recall correctly. At the beginning, I was really weak to Volcarona, so I made some changes. And I was also weak to Double Dance Landers. So the first mon is Bronzong, which was added later on when I was so weak to Double Dance Landers. It's really nice to check Mega Metagross, Tapu Lele, and it just gets up rocks, hits the HP Ice to hit Zygarde. I mean, you don't want to like stay in on Zygarde because you get hit super effective by 1000 arrows. But on the off chance, you just don't need this anymore and you don't want Zygarde getting up a free sub, you can just click HP Ice. We have Tapu Fini with more Spadaf. Am I missing some EVs? Yeah, I'm missing a lot of EVs. I'm glad that I caught that. I was about to, okay, that's interesting. This is a more of a Spadef build to be able to check Ash Greninja real well. Since I have this max defense and my Venusaur, which you guys will see soon, is really defensive, so I made this more Spadef. Ash Greninja is a problem. Venusaur should be able to deal with most Greninjas that are not extra sensory. Making this more defensive could be nice to check Zygarde, because Zygarde is really annoying for this team. But I will keep it at Spadef for now. We have 96 speed, a lot of Phoenix run less speed. But it's the standard spread that, the spread that Jammet and Ricardo always use to shoutouts to these two guys. Scald is interesting, is an interesting choice. I wanted to be able to hit Marowak, Landorus, and just be able to burn mons that are not grounded like Celesteela. Because Celesteela is a bit annoying to this team. I mean, Hooper is good versus Celesteela, but I don't want to switch Hooper in. So next mon, Mega Venusaur, almost max defense. The reason this is almost max defense is Mega Morwall got released. And I'm not trying to get steamrolled by Mega Morwall. So most Mega Morwalls don't run Iron Head these days. So I thought it was a really nice idea to run a fat Venusaur. Shoutouts to Padlop. I run even more defense than him though. Maybe it's probably smarter to run some Spadef. But yeah, HP Fire just to hit Morwall, hit Ferrothorn. Standard Venusaur, not much to explain. And we got Scarf and Heligo next to check Volcarona. Thunder is interesting to hit Celesteela and to be able to get some paras. It's a bit risky, I guess Seabolt might be better in some scenarios. HP Fire is really nice here because I have to double HP Fire here these 2 months. And I can predict Mega Metagross to come in and get some nice 30 to 40 chip damage. This was just needed for speed control. Next one is Bandit Hooper, so we have something to wall break a bit. Shoutouts to Advanced Ship for this Brett. I might link his RMT down below. I can show you guys real quick. Here's the RMT he made. It's called Make Talon Flame Great Again, or Make Talon Great Again peaked on the suspect ladder. And he's saying you can run a Fire Punch on this Hooper, but since I have Mega Morwall is out, right? So you can run Fire Punch to Oko. That it's a roll to Oko. If Morwall here, you have to calc here. If Morwall has 88 HP, you have 87% chance to Oko it with Bandit Fire Punch. So this spread is really interesting. It allows you to live a U-turn from Ash Greninja, and it allows you to take an Earthquake. He says that minus one from Ductria. So we have to intimidate from Landorus though. That could be nice. Zenithbat is to hit Toxapex, Gunkshot for Tapu Fini, Ice Punch to Oko, Zygarde and Landorus. Zygarde can be really annoying to this team, the bulky Zygarde set. Hyperspace Fury is also nice to hit through Substitute when Zygarde gets up a Substitute. I've been talking for way too long, I feel like. We should get it going right. Last one, Double Dance Landorus. I went for Adamant here. Jolly is probably better to speed up with opposing Lando. I just wanted the power because I'm not trying to lose to some fat team. This is why we have these two wall breakers here at the end. But Z-move, Continental Crush to break through Skarmory. And let's just get a game. I feel like I forgot something. I wanted to mention something else. So yeah, SPL weekend is around the corner. And I'm probably not going to be able to record Roads to Top 10. When we are nearing the week, because I want to record a lot of SPL. So yeah, I'm not sure how this is going to go. Other problems is I don't have that many more good teams, and I have a few more good teams, but it's going to be tough. I will have to build some more and like listen around. So Wobbuffet is interesting because Shadow Tech is banned, so I don't know what he's trying to do with his Wobbuffet. This could be like Scarf or Specs type Flosion. We are still relatively low on the ladder. We left off on a 12-hander 2 days ago when I last recorded. So I think he's gonna lead with this or this, so I wanna stop these two. Venusaur should be fine to, if he leads Absol exactly. And if he leveled Typhlosion, I could have switched into either Terpofini or Nihiligo. I feel like Nihiligo would have been fine, because he might have been like Eruption Specs, and I don't want Nihiligo to take 5 million from that. I mean Terpofini. So this turn I can just go for Sludge Bomb. If he goes to Mantine, I can fish for a Poison. If he stays in, he needs to have Psychic Cuts to be able to hit me hard, so he goes for SD. It's 2-hit KOs him, obviously. We get a Poison turn 1, we are really lucky. So the question is, do I need this healthy for anything? This would be really nice for the Sylveon and for the Hitmontop. Since I'm really defensive, I might just be able to click Synthesis here. Eat up his hit, he went for Sucker Punch, he had no reason to go for Sucker Punch, he's faster. And I can just go for Synthesis again now. Yeah, this is the low ladder. Yeah, he switched out, but that's completely fine. I can just guard into my Tapofini here, so I cannot get Scald Burned. If he wants to go for Air Slash, that's not gonna do any damage either. Yeah, I was wondering why in testing this took so much damage from Greninja. I was about to say, like, why did I take so much damage? And yeah, we just realized earlier on I was missing EVs. Toxic would be amazing because we could Toxic this in the air. Nature's Madness would be nice here for the Sylveon. I gotta say that. Nature's Madness is nice in some scenarios. I feel like I can just fire off a Moonblast here, or I could double switch into okay, just Sex off his Absol, that's completely fine. So we got our leftovers back and we're almost at full, looking nice and healthy. I don't know what Wobbuffet is gonna do, but I'm just gonna taunt this. So he's going for counter when I have Moonblast, interesting. Like, this is not physical. I'm also not trapped, so I can just go to my Bandit Hooper here and just blow something away with Hyperspace Fury. Like, I don't really care if you want to go to Sylveon, go ahead. This could be Sash, so maybe this is not a good idea. This could be Sash with counter. Hooper. Do I need Hooper this game? Hooper is really nice to break through Mantine, Mantine. So I don't want to just go for that and just... If he's Sash and he blows me away, or if he's Cobra Berry or something, I don't want to go for that. So what is the better play? I feel like a good play is... going to Landris here. And I can SD up on this. Yeah, that's a better play. Yeah, exactly. I don't want to... get countered, and I feel like I can like go for Rock Polish here in case he wants to, so I'm able to outspeed his potential Scarf Typhlosion later on. This might have Toxic. He's just letting me set up. I guess if he's I can just keep doing this until he has no counters left. If he doesn't have Toxic, I just set up on this for days. Like, I'm never gonna fall for your counter. Like, even if you're Sash, I'm just gonna keep doing this until you are out of PP. And now I can Rock Polish spam. Rock Polish has 32 PP, so I have enough PP through. Like, he cannot keep doing this. Like, I don't know what this guy's doing. I guess he's just inexperienced. Like, he must be Sash. That's the only reason to, like, make the play he's making. But it doesn't work, dude. It doesn't work. I can just keep clicking Rock Polish or SD. They both have 32 PP. Like, maybe I should speed this up, because this is really just boring, but... if the guy wants to keep clicking counter, let him keep click counter. There's 20 left. If he switches out, I just, like, this just runs through his team. Like, we outspeed everything, we even outspeed a potential unburden Hitmonlee after fake out and if it gets the unburden. So safeguard, nice option, but it doesn't save you, my friend. I have so many PP, like, oh, his safeguard has 40 PP, and he has Destiny Bond, okay. So I guess now he's starting to click different moves, which is a bit annoying, but now he switched out, and yeah, I can just go for... I can just go for the Z move here. I don't wanna miss on this. I just wanna get the Mantine out of here. Like, I just set up this Landris to plus 6, so this is the only thing I had to hit with Stone Edge. Everything else dies to Earthquake, so there was no point I was gonna, there was no way I was gonna risk missing a Stone Edge on that. When he could have burnt me there and just taken away all my boost. Okay, he just forfeits, which is what he should have done a few turns ago. This team is definitely not perfect. Of course, every team has flaws. We are a bit weak to Alolan Muk. We have a Landris, but if that get poison on the switch in, that would be annoying. We get some fat team, which Hooper should have a lot of fun versus. Fire Punch would be really nice versus the Magiena, but I don't have Fire Punch. Maybe I should first put Fire Punch over Ice Punch. So this should be winnable. Landris does some work, but the Quagsire is in the way. I don't know if can I afford to like have rocks on both sides. I'm thinking what I want to leave with this guy. I think I would just want to leave with Hooper. If he doesn't leave with McGee, and I'm in a good position. I can just fire off a Bandit Hyperspace Fury here. If he goes to Magiena, that should at least do 30%. And if he stays in, he has to hope for a burn. And like chipping this Magiena away, yeah, that's a lot. Chipping at this Magiena is gonna be amazing. I assume this is gonna be a Salt Vest or Z-move. I'm not even sure. And yeah, Venusaur should be fine, or Bronzong should be fine. Let me think what is better here. Venusaur to get off the Mega Evolution to get extra bulk is really nice. As this guy is unexperienced and runs Dazzling Gleam. Like, why would you want Dazzling Gleam or Flurkin? I feel like the Blissey is gonna come out here. So I kinda wanna double switch into Landers or Hooper, but if he like Volt switches. Yeah, I wanna double switch into Hooper here, bringing the Blissey. If he stays in and Volt switch, I'm gonna be pissed. Goes to Gliscor. So we can go for Bandit Ice Punch here. We should outspeed unless he's super fast. And we can kill his Gliscor with an Ice Punch. Amazing. So that Ice Punch coming in clutch, like. If he has Pursuit, that's gonna be really, really bad. So you either go for Bandit Bullet Punch or U-turn. I think it's gonna go for Bandit U-turn here. So I don't wanna go into my Venusaur because I'm not Mega'd yet. I wanna go into Landris as a mid-ground play, even though I'm offensive Landris. Maybe Bronzong was the better play. He's Mega Scissors, yeah. This is fine with me. He just goes for Superpower. I can just Earthquake here, like, he's probably gonna go to Quagsire. But in case he stays in, I just wanna get some nice damage off. Yeah, doubling into Venusaur would've been nice there, but it's fine. That does a lot. So he's forced to heal here. I can honestly just spam Earthquake, fish for a crit. I can also just go hard into Hooper here. Cause he's forced to. Oh, he goes for Toxic, okay. So if I Earthquake there, he would've gone to it code. I don't agree with not recovering, but I'm just gonna fire off another Hyperspace Fury. And if he goes to Magiena, if he stays in, he's gonna eat it up, wow. But I mean, the next one kills him, so yes, he weakened my Hooper, but yeah, I guess now he can switch into Magiena, but okay, he switches into Scizor. Takes 500 million. He's probably just gonna Bullet Punch or heal up, so I just want to go back into Landris, because Landris has offensive presence. Bronzong is just a sitting duck and allows him to heal, so I don't want to go to Bronzong. And now just Earthquake spam. Or even SD. The only reason I'm Earthquaking here is because I don't want him to go hard into Quagsire. He SDs up for some reason. I should still be able to lift this because Landris has natural bulk, even though I'm offensive. And he doesn't even go for Bullet Punch, he just sacks his Scizor. Yeah, this guy didn't play well. I mean, I didn't play optimal this game, but this guy's just playing super weird. I'm not even sure if Scarven, Heligo, Oko's superior, but I kind of want. I trust my Heligo, I'm gonna bring it out. I could also go to Venusaur. I'm just gonna go to Scarven, Heligo, and fire off a Sludge Wave here, as he is Focus Sash superior, so this might kill me. Yes, yes, it does kill. So we don't 6-0, but we don't have to 6-0. That was my Scarfer, so this is actually bad. I'm actually in a really bad position now. Let me pause it and calc real quick. So the cog says Bronzong takes 84% max. I gotta double check if I miscalc this. Plus 4 special attack versus Bronzong. Yes, this is my spread. So he shouldn't be able to kill me. And the reason I'm going Bronzong over Venusaur is Venusaur is really nice to keep versus his Magearna. And yeah, what I'm just gonna do is just Gyro Ball here. As if he crit me there, it would have been really, really bad. But yeah, thankfully no crit. I still think Venusaur would have been able to take a hit. Yeah, but Venusaur probably was able to take any hit. But Venusaur is just really, really nice to just switch in on this Magearna and Wallet. As yeah, he gets a crit with Aura Sphere, that is fine with me. I can just synthesis up. If he goes to Blissey, fine with me. If he stays in, fine with me. I don't care. I just want to keep this healthy. As he's, that actually does a lot of damage. So if he gets this Bedevil drop, this is actually gonna be bad. As he's a Assault Vest, that does nothing. We can synthesis up again. We should have this game in the bag with our Bandit Hooper pretty much. I just don't wanna like choke it away. Yeah, hopefully no Bedevil drop. Damn, this is doing so much. But yeah, I don't need my Venusaur. The only thing I need Venusaur for is... actually, I need it for Quirksa, kind of. Wait, how much... Yeah, this Quirksa's at 60. So if I have my Bandit Hooper around, I should be fine versus this Quirk. I gotta pause it after this one to get something to drink. Let me synthesis again. If he gets a Spedef drop, it's gonna be bad. I can just 2-hit KO him here, like... There's no point in risking a crit. Okay, that's a Spedef drop, yeah. He can switch out, but he just sacks it. I mean, this Magearna wasn't doing anything, but he could have kept it as fodder at least, which is like... I don't know why he's going to this, because I can just Giga Drain this, and I just get all my health back, so... He didn't have a win condition, but yeah. He still could have gone to Blissey first. 70 minutes in, let me pause it real quick and be right back with the next one. Gotta get something to drink. We are 9-0 now. It's starting off nice, but we're gonna get triads pretty soon. Oh yeah, we are back. Okay, I forgot. I wasn't sure if I unpaused. Here we go, we're gonna look for another one. As we get mono bug. This might like seem like it's a mono bug, it might not be that scary, but this is a Volcarona and a Pinsir, which are super, super scary. I feel like it's I cannot even get Rocks up because this just spins versus Bronzong. So he's either gonna leave with Galvantula or the Fortress. If he doesn't have HPS on his Galvantula, Landorus is really nice to set up on that. I feel like Venusaur is a good lead to get off the Mega Evolution as he leads Vikavolt. Okay, I wasn't expecting him to leave a Vikavolt. Just HP Fire in case he goes into Fortress. And if he stays in, it still has good damage. Okay, he's Volt Switch. So, he's Life Orb. That didn't work out for my opponent. But now, if he brings in Volcarona, I'm forced to go. Okay, he brings in Pinsir. Really, really huge, really, really huge threat. I think I'm forced to go into Bronzong. Nihiligo's too important to keep healthy for his Volcarona, so this is really scary. That didn't do much, but I just want to get Rocks up for this, or Gyro Ball. I think Rocks are more important. As he has knockoff on his Pinsir, so call it a counter team. Call it a counter team. So I just lose my Bronzong here. It's just really bad. I can switch out into Landorus because he has to knock off again to kill me. If he's gonna go for return here, this is gonna be so bad. But I feel like he's gonna knock off again. Oh yeah, he goes for off. Okay, that made no sense. What? I'm gonna go for Rock Polish or SD. I feel like SD is the play because he should switch. He should switch into his Fortress and I wanna SD and break his Fortress. Honestly, I want to go for game with this, so. But I feel like I need rocks up to break the Sash on the Garvanchla. We will just get big damage here with an Earthquake because he wants to spin for his Pinsir. See, as I got dragged out, oh. Red card, that's interesting. So. I can just go for HP Fire here. That lets the HP Fire lets the Araquanid in, which would force me to sack my Bronzong pretty much. Now I make sure, maybe if Power Jump kills us, I can go for Power Jump. Let me just calc this real quick. My Helico versus Fortress. Yeah, Power Jump does 55. I just didn't want to risk anything. Just making sure. Get my beast boost. This might just sweep. This might just win. Because everything is weak to Power Jam. Yeah, we got the beast boost on deck. We are scarfed. Pinsir is not the counter. I don't know why Pinsir is the counter. Yeah, we just win with Nihilego now. That's amazing. Get another beast boost. Yeah, the Marowak meta is coming around, and I also wanted to test Mega Beedrill. I don't think Mega Beedrill is that good. I have made one team with Beedrill, which was Voltron. It has been work. I only have played two games with it. I haven't tested it enough to say if it's good. I don't think it's that good. The only thing Beedrill has going for it is it has Poison Jab, it outspeeds Tapu Koko, as we will just finish this off with Power Gym. It outspeeds Tapu Koko, and it's nice to kill up with Poison Jab, kill Tapu Fini with Poison Jab. Man said GG. GG, my man. Yeah, shoutouts to my boy Nihilego. Just one of my favorite Scarfers lately. Beast Boost is a cool ability. He has a Charizard. Not only is Beast Boost a cool ability, it also has a nice speed tier. It's able to outspeed Volcarona after a Quiverdance. Has really nice spadav. I think it lifts a Hydro Pump from Greninja if I'm. Yeah. Not sure about specs, but I'm pretty sure it lifts a Life Orb Hydro Pump. So. I don't know why he said that. Yeah, I mean, I'm Scarf, so that was why I was faster. That's why I outspent your Pinsir, my dude. I mean, it's pretty obvious, but in case he doesn't know, I guess I can tell him. This doesn't get Aqua Jet, I think, and they never run it, like, at least. Yeah, I don't think it does. So, GG, my dude, we will grab another one. We are 1269, and we might have decayed a bit, because. Like I said, I haven't played since 2 days ago, as we have a Talonflame on the opposing side, so that could be a Z-move Talonflame. Probably Mega Metagross, which is really scary. Como is actually a big threat depending on its set. Like if it's banned, if it's specs, I don't have good switch-ins. I mean, I have a Tapu Fini, yeah, I have a Tapu Fini, but if it's like Dragon Dance with Poison Jab, that can get a bit annoying. Oh, it could also be Z-move. Nah, but that should be able. We should be able to deal with that. Belly Drum could be annoying to break the Fini. So, I don't want him leading with. Ah, this is annoying that he has a Magnezone to trap this. I know I have Earthquake, but Earthquake doesn't OKO and he 2KOs me. But overall, Bronzong seems okay. Yeah, also, this Hooper lives a Meteor Mash from Metagross, so I can just leave with this and fire off a Hyperspace Fury. Not like he has any switch-ins. Como will take a lot. Como's is only resist, so we'll just go for that banded Hyperspace Fury. Magnezone lives, which is a bit disappointing. But yeah, we tank that Volt Switch. Hooper has really nice spadav. Hooper is one of these mons that might get, in my opinion, might get suspect tested later on. When the meta has developed, when stuff like Greninja got tested, stuff like Metagross, which is. Greninja and Metagross need to be tested really badly, in my opinion. Would have been nice to keep this at full to take a hit from this, but. If I switched out there, I just lost momentum, unless I went into Landorus. So I'm just gonna go Bronze Line because it's my check for Metagross. And I don't really see what else I can switch into this monster. Hopefully no attack race. That would be brutal if you got a boost. And I think I can fire off Earthquakes. Oh, I can get up Rocks. Getting up Rocks is really nice here for the Talonflame. And he goes for Earthquake. Okay, I'm a Levitate Bronzong. I guess this is what happens when you play on the low ladder, I guess. So yeah, I will just Earthquake here. In case he thinks I doesn't have anything to hit him. Of course he gets the boost. So my Bronzong is gonna get weakened, but this is the main, like, I don't need my Bronzong for anything besides this. As he misses. Which is nice, not gonna lie. We take those. Talonflame comes in, that's fine, but fine with me. I feel like I can go Heart Nihiligo or Tapufini, and yeah, I think Heart Nihiligo is fine. Like, Nihiligo is not sweeping this game with Garchomp and Roserade. Actually, his Magnezone is already weakened and his Metagross, so if I get a Beast Boost later on, I could potentially even sweep with Nihiligo, but I don't think he would. Okay, he's, oh my god, I forgot Nihiligo has Trash Defense, and this looks like, is it Banded Talonflame? But the good thing is Talonflame only has Gale Wings when it's at 100%, so I'm gonna be able to outspeed him, and I can just go for Power Gem here. Pick off his Talonflame, get a Beast Boost. I'm gonna be forced out here probably by Garchomp, or if he goes to Roserade, I can get good damage on that. Yeah, but I don't want to stay in our Garchomp. I can go to my Bronzong, do my Landorus. This is a Stealth Rocker. I feel like I can go to Bronzong and fire off an HPIs. That just seems like a good play. His Metagross is already weakened, so. And I was thinking he would go for Rocks or Earthquake there. So that we can just fire off an HPIs, or he just says he doesn't want to play anymore. So we'll just grab another one. I'm gonna make these, like, the last one was 35 minutes and then it was a bit of me talking at the end. So we got Sticky Webs, which I haven't faced yet with this team. This might be scary. I think we should be able to deal with it. Potential Mega Aerodactyl. So how do I not let him get up too many layers? I either lead with Hoopa. I think leading with Hoopa is fine. Because the Shuckle should get 2 killed. How much does Nihiligo do to Shuckle? The thing is, he has a Celesteela to Wallmine Nihiligo. Shuckle gets 2 killed, so that's an option. But I think I just want to lead off with Hoopa. If this has Infestation, I'm gonna take 5 million, but yeah, I'm just gonna go for the Hyperspace Fury, as that's a roll to 2 KO, because this Hoopa's not max attack. I really hope I get this roll, because I don't want to deal with rocks. Thankfully, we get the roll. Sticky Webs, I can defog away later if I need this. If I need my Scarf and Helicopter to outspeed his Aerodactyl, but I have some checks to his Aerodactyl, especially Bronzong. Landorus if it doesn't have Ice Fang, and I don't know why Toxapex is the counter. Maybe he has Baneful Bunker. I think I'm just gonna use this opportunity to go hard into Tapu Fini and defog his webs away, so I don't not really sure what he's doing. Yeah, I thought he might be a Baneful Bunker. This is the type of guy to run Baneful Bunker on a ladder. Awful set, but thankfully I get the free defog here. As he has Toxic Spikes, I can defog once more, and if he goes for T-Spikes again, I'm gonna taunt him. So he tries to Toxic me in the Misty Terrain, now I'm gonna taunt him so he cannot go for T-Spikes. As he's gonna Scald me. Also, I have a Nihiligo, so I didn't have to defog. And now I'm just gonna go hard into my Bandit Hoopa, because I cannot get burned in Misty Terrain. As Celesteela comes out, and I don't wanna lose my Hoopa, because if I go for Hyperspace Fury, my Hoopa is like my main way of breaking his Toxapex. I also have a Landorus. I think I'm fine, yeah. Weakening the Celesteela is great. Cause like, what am I switching in if he's offensive? Yeah, this is 2 points faster than max speed Celesteela. I think I just have to go for this Hyperspace Fury. Do 5 million. Hopefully he's not Heavy Slam. Or he's just gonna go for a Totemize. So he's leftover, so I don't think he can kill me. Maybe with Heavy Slam, but if he's the special side, he cannot kill me. I hope he's a special set with Air Slash as hopefully no flinches. Amazing. Get rid of the Status Stealer. Everything is going well. Everything is going fine. I should have this game in the back. Now he can go to Greninja if he has U-turn. Oh, Hydroplane might even kill me if he specs. I can go Typo Fini, but if he gong shots, it's gonna be bad. But I'm gonna attempt to save this because it's the main way of beating his Toxic Packs. As he's Ash Greninja, okay. Ash Life, oh, that's interesting. Don't see that every day. I can just fire off a Moonblast. Yes, Gold hasn't been doing much on this. I guess Nature's Madness might be better. But Marowak is kind of a threat to this team, I feel like. Gartana taking a lot. Gartana should be checked by Venusaur pretty well. Also by Bronzong. But Venusaur is my best play. It has HP Fire. And Psychic Cut would be his best move to hit me if he has that. Leaf Blade does absolutely nothing. As he just forfeits. And I think I'm going to go to Braun more because that was rather short. I hope this is not the one where it goes down. Because we have been doing so well. And of course we get rain now, so it's going to be scary. Yeah, we face a Marowak, so Scald boosted Rain Boosted Scald will be nice in this matchup. But he has a Ferrothorn, so he can just bring that in on my Fiend. So the Pelipper lead is obvious. I just want to lead with... The thing is, if he has U-turn, my Hooper is going to get blown out of the window, so let me Kulk. I don't think I can kill... the Pelipper. I'm not max attack on the Hooper. This Fist Dev, I cannot kill him, and U-turn doesn't kill me though, even if I'm minus one. Because I have like the, I have defense investment on this Hooper, so yeah, I think Hooper's a fine lead then. As he leads with Tapu Koko, this might have for U-turn. Which makes me not want to stay in, which makes me want to go Venusaur. Venusaur would have also been a potential lead. The only reason I didn't want to leave with Venusaur is the Pelipper right there, which could be help me with a Hurricane. But yeah, Venusaur does pretty well in this match. If rain is not up, it can hit the Ferrothorn. The Landorus might be Z-move. It's probably Z-move. The question is if it's Continental Crush or Sky Strike. But yeah, I have a Bronzong to check his Landorus pretty well. This Coco is a bit annoying though. Like, I would like to stay in, but if he has U-turn, yeah, okay, Thunder. Thunder makes sense on a rain team. So hopefully no Para, and I'm thinking hopefully no Brave Bird or anything to kill me. Yeah, actually I'm max defense, I live Brave Bird easily. I can just synthesis up here. This is really nice to have healthy. As he's gonna go for Taunt, so I'm getting plate like shirts already. I'm gonna go for Sludge Bomb here. Sludge Bomb last time would have been amazing. So that was a risky play by my opponent, which worked out really aggressive. I don't know why this was the switch. I should have gone for Giga Drain. No poison, so I'm just gonna go my Bronzong. How do I heal my? The only way I heal this is on a Ferrothorn, I think. On a Kingdra locked into Turf or something. So this guy knows what he's doing, it seems like, and this is really scary, and I'm forced to go for HP Ice because there's a plus 2 Landorus in my... just setting up in my face. Yeah, if he can win this, this is gonna be amazing. This is the first match this life, this is really tough, that is really tough to win. Because he made that really great play. Maybe I should have just gone for Sludge Bomb, but... it made sense for me, like, I want to keep my Venusaur healthy, right? And I was low on the ladder and I was facing bad plays, so I didn't expect that. Really great play on his part, I should have gone for rocks. But yeah, I wasn't playing around with a Earthquake or rocks, that would have been amazing. I wasn't playing around with a plus 2 Landorus in my face, like I said. But I honestly could have afforded... I could have gone for rocks there. That was my fault. Okay, I have to concentrate now, I have to play better. This guy is no joke. He knows what's popping. He's taking his sweet time too, which is making me nervous. Like, it's not making me nervous, it's a bit annoying, but I wish this was more defensive now. Scald doesn't... I don't think Scald killed this. I hope Scald kills, because he's not gonna expect it, but... okay, he just goes feral. Does he know my team or something? Because usually you wouldn't expect us to have Scald. Yeah, I don't want to taunt this, and if he power whips, it's gonna be super bad. Just goes for durable. I can heal my Venusaur here. If he stays there and goes for Hazard, it's gonna be bad. Marowak comes back, but Mimikarka, how much Venusaur takes. Venusaur. Oh my boy, guy, oh boy, oh boy. This Marowak is such a problem. I think I'll lose this, yeah. Might have to get one more then, because I don't want to end on a loss. Adamant versus Venusaur. We have a lot of defense on this. We have 263 defense. HP. Twenty-six defense? 375 defense. Oh, I was cocking regular Venus, so my bad, my bad. Okay, okay. So Shadow Bone doesn't do that much. So I can... I cannot fish for poison because there's... I'm just gonna Giga Drain. Oh, he's fast, Marowak. How is he faster? Oh my god, I lose this. This guy's Jolly Marowak. So I can Synthesis up here. He's... Oh my god! He gets the burn, which is so huge. This burn is so huge. I would have been able to, like, Synthesis up easily. Come on, dude. Of course he gets the defense drop too. Like, what am I supposed to do now? Like, I'm gonna go my Landris. I'm gonna take 5 million from this. Earlier he played really well, but this Hex is just... Don't burn this. I mean, I got salty there. Just gonna fire off a Continental Crush here, bleeding his Landris. Now, he's either gonna go Landris or Ferrothorn here, I feel. So how can I take advantage of this situation? Like, if I SD and he goes into Landris, I just... Yeah, I guess I'm gonna... Okay, he just sacks his mirror. Okay, rip. Rip my dreams, rip everything. Just gonna attempt the defog. He's probably just gonna sack this, but he has a Ferrothorn, which is a free switch. And this was a rough matchup. I didn't play well this game. Okay, we live. That's something. But he can just go Ferrothorn here. But I'm not gonna double because he keeps staying in. Yeah, I almost doubled there. So I lost my Landris, which is really annoying. I didn't need Landris for much, but it would've been nice to weaken his Ferrothorn. The burn on my Venusaur, which annoyed me the most. Burn and the defense drop. Like, the burn was even more annoying. Because my Venusaur doesn't have that longevity now. I can hope to dodge the thunder, but of course he hits. Like, this guy gets all the luck in the world. He plays well, but, like, risking thunder there, I don't know if that was the play to make. I'm gonna go on a Heligoon, I have to go for HP fire, I have to play aggressive now. I'm in the bag, like, why would you stay in here, right? Yeah. I have to go for HP fire, and now I have to predict him again. The thing is, he could have Protect, but he should go to Pelipper or Kingdra here, so... I'm gonna go Hooper. If he stays in, he stays in. Okay, we predict him there. So we're slowly coming back into this game, and we can just fire off Hyperspace Fury. If he's not defensive, he can potentially Oko him. He's defensive, and hopefully he doesn't have U-turn, but he has U-turn, but thankfully we live that. Get some juicy defense investments. Hooper being weakened is huge though, now Kingdra just comes in. Yeah, my Tapofini, letting my Tapofini die. Now it's even more huge that my Venusaur is burned. I cannot check his Kingdra at all. Yeah, Kingdra just steamrolls. Kingdra just steamrolls me. So he's just gonna go for Thunder. And I feel like I have to save this to have a sec later on. I'm gonna go Heart and Heligo. If he paralyzes me with Thunder, I can just click X. Okay, goes for U-turn. That was obviously his better play. The Kingdra is here, the Kingdra is now. We just lose. If he's modest, though, I would speed him, but I cannot Oko him anyway. Yeah, if my Venus... His modest, how much speed does he have? 269, which is still faster. I have to set my Uber. Yeah, I lose this game. Not sure if the hex matters. Why would you risk a Draco there? Oh, you predicted my Venusaur. Ferrothorn should wall me, but I think I'm forced to HP fire. Make a hard read. And now I'm not gonna overpredict. Like, he can go to Pelipper here, but I think I have to HP fire again. If you wanna go to Pelipper, go ahead, be my guest. Okay, nothing we can do, we just lose. Like, what am I supposed to do about this not honorable matchup, I had a Tapu Fini for Kingdra. So my play now is to dodge Hydro Pumps, but he's just gonna go for Surf. He keeps risking Draco. Yeah, this guy deserves to lose for making this bad play. Like, why is he risking this? I don't think I have a win condition because he has Surf on this. I'm gonna go for Power Gen here. Hopefully this tweet kills the Ferrothorn as it should. No, it doesn't even. Hopefully I get this roll. I mean, I could have played this a bit better, but... Oh my god! I could have played this better. But yeah, I haven't faced Rain when I was testing with this team, as... He's just getting healthier, we're not getting the crit. Crit is my only win condition at this point. I'm gonna say GG and forfeit. Like, honestly... He played good at the beginning, but I don't know. But he disconnected. Did he disconnect after the game? Or is it me that disconnected? I don't know, it's probably me. But I'm still online, so I don't know why it says that. So yeah, we're gonna grab one more. And we get Rain again. So that last loss, that loss was painful. I'm gonna have to be careful now that I don't go on tilt. So he has Pelipper again. We will just lead with Hooper again. And yeah, people keep leading with this. But this time I will just stay in. And Zen Headbutt. The thing is, if he has U-turn and he goes Scizor. But yeah, I'm gonna Zen Headbutt in case he... In case he stays in. But he should just U-turn a voltage out. But the Scizor's not mega, so it will take a lot. So this match, I have to keep my Tapu Fini healthy for the Kingdra. That was the mistake I made last match. But his Marowak was just overwhelming. Like, I don't know what I could have done when he... Like, if his Marowak didn't burn and defense drop my Venus, so I could have 1v1'd him with recover spam. Hopefully we connect as we get paralyzed and we miss. So that is amazing. Don't you all love Pokemon? So yeah, there we go. The tilt is here, the tilt is now. Like, I'm just gonna lose a few games now. So this Tapu Koko would have died turn one, but instead of a dead Tapu Koko, my Hooper is paralyzed and it doesn't even do shit. It might not be chancy still, but maybe not even that. You can just Volt out into this chancy. This is just, or you can even go to Torn. Like, this is just frustrating. Yes, it's Pokemon, I choose to play this game. Hex happens. I fully understand PokeM now. Why would you go hard into Torn if you're not a Solve? I said it so much. Dude, if I poisoned you there... He might knock off my Nihiligo, but I think I have to go hard Nihiligo. Like, I don't have Switch into Torn. And I want to double Switch, but in case this guy's bad and wants to stay in on U-turn, I'm gonna just Power Jam. I think I have to double Switch on his Chansey. How much speed does Chansey hit? 136, so it outspeeds my Hooper. This is really stupid. The para. So I have to double the pressure as Chansey, which would be to go to Torn. As he stays in, this is why I should have power jammed. I love good players. I'm gonna get so mad. This guy made the worst play in existence. Like, no, that's just not a good play. You just sacked your Torn. Yeah, I'm gonna come in and crush this. If he scarf, good job, but I don't think you are. I'm gonna just at least get rid of his Rain. Amazing, amazing. We can still win this match. Let's calm down a bit. Let's calm down a bit. It's not we only lost one game. That's not our downfall. That's not a downfall. But it's low ladder, so it makes me so mad when I lose low ladder already. Hydroform does a ton. And I think I'm forced to Moonblast here. I want to double on this Chansey, but this guy was playing really awful earlier, so I'm not gonna make any predictions like that. It's really hard to predict players that make weird plays like that. Why was Scizor the play there? Why was Scizor the play there? That made no sense. You have a Chansey, I guess, in case NH's Madness. But this also doesn't beat me. Yeah, I guess he doesn't have good answers for this, but I just don't get what Scizor's his answer. I just cannot afford to stay in, because Kingdra is too scary, so I want to just go into my Venusaur or into my Landorus. And I feel like Landorus is better, because I don't want to go Venusaur, take a Bandit U-turn to the face. He's Mega, obviously. Venusaur would have been nice, but... yeah, I think I might just lose to the Scizor now. Okay, that's a lot. ESD'd again. Yeah, these players are just greedy and bad. Why didn't he roost there? I guess I could have SD'd, so roosting maybe would have not been the play. That kills? Wow. That kills? I know I'm offensive Landers, but still. So yeah, I kind of just lose to Scizor now. So let my Tapu Fini take the hit, I lose to Kingdra, so... I have to calculate how much Venusaur takes. I might just have to go to Tapu Fini. The thing is, I think I just lose this one. He's +3, right? And he killed my Landorus. So I have to calc +4 versus Landorus. Yeah, maybe I should run bulky double down to Landorus, that's smarter. So 80 to 95 and it hit 91, so that was a high roll if he's that spread. But if he's not that spread, if he's max attack... actually, my Earthquake does 40, I can calc from how much... yeah, Earthquake does that much. So this spread makes sense. So how much does my Venusaur take from this spread? 52 to 68, but I'm a bit more defensive, so it's a roll in my favor. It's a roll in my favor because I'm really defensive on my Venusaur. HP Fire doesn't kill though because the rain is up. And how much does Tapu Fini take? Pretty sure I'll lose this. I'm not Calm Mind, I'm just trying to figure out. 243 to 70 defense. Oh, I'm not bold on my Fini here. Yeah, Bullet Punch killed. So Venusaur's my only play. Yeah, I just lose this. I think Synthesis is better because next turn the rain ends and I can kill him. Okay, nice. We eat that up. Wait, I forgot! I just choked! Oh my god, I just choked! But HP Fire wouldn't have killed him. HP Fire wouldn't have killed him anyway, so what was my option there? I had to go for HP Fire crit, yeah, I choked this. Yeah, I just lose. Rip my life, I just lose. I didn't think this team was weak to Scizor because I had a Venusaur, but my Venus, since the rain was up, obviously Scizor was like, yeah, Bronzong doesn't do shit. I can just click X. Like, my only play was to go on Nihiligo was my only hope, and hope he doesn't click Bullet Punch. Nihiligo and hope he doesn't click Bullet Punch is my only play. God, this is so painful. Why are you setting up? You just win, dude. Just end me. So yeah, I'm gonna get really mad now. You guys can leave a dislike, I don't, like, if, like, I deserve it. For not, like, I should have gone for HP Fire, that was awful. That was so awful, good god. I mean, I lost the game anyway. But if I got, went for HP Fire, maybe he had less depth than the standard Scizor, and I could have killed him, yeah. Let me say GG in 4-5. Wow, that was painful. Like, I never faced Rain in testing, and now I got Rain twice, but Rain was not the problem, Scissor was the problem. But Rain made the Scissor so powerful that it became a problem. So yeah, this is gonna be a long episode, this is painful. I didn't expect to struggle this low on the ladder. I guess my team is not as good as I thought it was. Should have tested it more. This will happen. I use teams that I haven't tested enough. So he's probably Z-move Gyarados, but he could be Mega Gyarados and Z-move Mimikyu or Z-move Landorus or Formosa. He has a lot of options. I'm just gonna have to be careful that I don't get salty. Yeah, I didn't think my plays through 100%. I feel like I just could have played better. Venusaur should be fine in this one. Okay, Gyarados. So no one goes for Sky Strike turn one. So I just want to go for Sludge Bomb, get damage off turn one. Expecting him to Dragon Dance, and next turn I can go to Bronzong, as I don't get a poison. My opponent can get a Thunder Paralysis, but I cannot get a poison, okay? Like in the other game. Like, yes, I lost to Scizor, not to the other thing, but still. So I might just lose to this. Maybe should have gone Heart and Heligo, but no, Heart and Heligo would have died to Sky Strike, I think. I mean, Gyarados World should be really strong since this guy Dragon Danced up, and I'm just this hit 287. Yeah, I might just get swept by this. Yeah, this is Z-move. This is Z-move, the way he's playing this. Sack Melandrus, but he has Moxie, which I forgot. So yeah, that was all for nothing. Getting the Intimidator was all for nothing. So I have to go Venusaur now, and then switch out on a Z-move. Set my Bronzong. And then he's gonna get a Moxie boost, which is really, 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 really bad. And he can just go for Bounce. So yeah, I just lose this too. I can go to Heligo on a Bounce. But yeah, if Heligo dies, which it might die, we're gonna say RIP. Nihiligo dies to Bounce, so yeah, we just get steamrolled now. I'm on tilt completely. How could I have played this different? I have no idea. I could have led off with Tapu Fini and gone for Taunt, so we only get one Dragon Dance. Yeah, that would have been a better play, maybe. But I didn't expect him just to lead with this. People are just lead mindless. Like, you should just get rocks up first. You shouldn't. This is not a mon you send out turn one, right? Zamrock swept early game with this, but he got rocks up first in Espia. So yeah, my only play is dodge. That's my only play, anyways. Which we don't get. GG. So yeah, RIP. RIP my win loss ratio. So yeah, we are 12-3 now. GXE is getting ruined, everything is going down. But yeah, I'm not envy, I'm gonna keep these losses in. But after I start losing, I just cannot play good anymore. Like, I just lose my... I just need a break, I get mad. So Volcarona lead. Not Volcarona lead. Volcarona is a threat, is what I meant, but we have the Nihiligo. This guy is a really, really odd team. Just wanna leave a Bronzong and get on my rocks. As, yeah, I said Volcarona lead and this guy actually did it. I don't know why. These people just lead with setup mons mildly and try to sweep. Like, I just don't like how they play, and it works out versus me. That's not how you play, you just don't, you... Set up turn one? No. I mean, I guess it can work. There was this one team in ours which has like 5 or 6 setup sweepers to just overpower. God, I have nothing to drink here, I cannot even speak anymore. Yeah, this life was really painful. This oh my god. Like, this is not really like good for my motivation to keep doing this. I mean, if I take L's like this, we're never gonna reach top 10, so I have to step my game up a bit. Versus the Scizor, yeah, this guy just sexes Volcarona. We're like low on the ladder again, so I'm not expecting too much since we lost three. Did we lose three in a row? That was, oh my god, heartbreaking. Like, this team, okay, this guy just forfeits, right? This team has been doing pretty well on this in the 1600s, but I guess I never faced rain. Scizor plus rain is scary. Like, I have a type of Feeny and a Venusaur, so usually I should be fine versus rain, but like, I'm just gonna have to get some wins now to, like, I don't want to end it off with, like, bad. Like, after these three outs, I have to get wins. So, Scizor lead. Should be Mega Scizor. Let's just go hard Venusaur. Yes, pursuit. Yeah, keep getting U-turn here and we lose the momentum. Okay, he just goes for Bullet Punch. Good. I want to double switch here, breaking his Heat Train, but I don't know how good this guy is. What's a good double I can make? I think Hooper is a good double, but if he goes for U-turn, my Hooper dies, so I'm gonna make the Landorus double. So if he U-turns, we don't take much damage at least. Yeah, exactly. Good players, man. If I HP fight you there, you lose your Scizor. I love good players, man. I cannot predict ladder players. Like, they make the most random plays. Why would I HP fire there when he has a Heatran in the back? Like, no, this is not how you play, dude. You just go to your Heatran. I guess if you scout for Earthquake, you could have gone to your Garchomp. Like, maybe you could have made a different mid-ground play. Like, if I HP fire and use Magma Storm Heatran and I give him a boost, what is my switch in next turn then? Like, nothing, I just get blown away then. If he's the Magma Storm and Bloom Bloom set. So yeah, now I have to deal with a Greninja, which could be... Since my Venusaur's not Mega Evolved, this will be a pain. If I knew this guy would just stay in, but... I could have Mega Evolved my Venusaur, but if he's the Gangshot one... Thankfully he's the Ash Greninja, which Tabofini can deal with. So he's gonna go to Ferrothorn here, or to... Ferrothorn, or his own Feeny, or his Scizor. So now I feel like I can make the Venusaur play. As now he makes the Heatran play? Now you make the Heatran play? Yeah, I cannot predict these people. Why is Heatran the counter to Tapu Fini? Yes, you're probably Magma Tran, but with Bloom Doom, but... I cannot predict these players. They make the most random plays, dude. Like, what? So Heatran is... That's the turn you go to Heatran? So I could have just Moonblast and then Scald next turn. Maybe Bloom just kills me. I need my Feeny for his Ash Ninja, so what is my play now? Like, Hooper gets 2-hit KO'd. If he's timid. I guess I have to go Nihiligo as this is my only resist to Magma Storm. He just gets up rocks. What if I had Earthquake? This guy didn't even scout, yeah. I don't like how ladder players play. Like, I want to go for HP Fire, but I don't think I can afford to make that play like that, yeah. KS Earth Power, that does 500 million, what the heck? So my Nihiligo dies to rocks. But getting damage off on Heatran is worth it, I guess. I think he has to be modest to do those types of damage to Nihiligo. Nihiligo versus Heatran. Offensive. Earth Power does 88. Never mind. 88. Oh, it's 4 times effective. I forgot. Oh my god. My bad. So Landorus is my play here. Just click Earthquake. Yeah. So we're on the back by a lot now. The Heatran play was odd. I was not expecting that. It makes some sense, because he's probably the Blue Moon Magma trend set with Earthbow and Rocks. But if I just I guess Moonblast would have done nothing, but like, I could have Scalded it, potentially. Like, he had a Ferrothorn, which was way safer to go into. I guess this play makes some sense, I cannot shit-talk it too much. Yeah. I definitely, like, I don't remember all the losses. I definitely could have avoided one of those three losses for sure. Yeah, I'm just forced to go Feeny. If he goes for U-turn, he keeps momentum, but there's not much I can do. He should go for U-turn. But he just goes for Hydro Pump, which is really nice, so I can defog. His Stealth Rocker is dead, unless he has rocks on his Ferro 2. Or on his Garchomp. His Garchomp is probably Scarf when he's, if he's Z-move Tren and spikes Ferro then. I don't know why he's not Mega Scissor though. He played like he was regular Scissor. Why did he not Mega Evolve? There's no reason to not Mega Evolve. I don't get it. Like, maybe he's not Mega, but I just don't get it. Keeps bringing Scissor instead of Ferrothorn, which I don't get. But yeah, I have to switch because I need this healthy and... Now I can go for HP Fire. Like, I'm not gonna over-predict anymore as this guy. I could have killed this earlier on. Okay, it lives one, but still, you see that's weak now. There's still heals on Ferrothorn, there still lives a hit from Scarf Chomp. It lives a hit from Ninja Locked in the pump. I don't know, Dark Pulse probably does a ton. But yeah, my ranking got ruined today. After everything went fine, I don't know why he went Ferrothorn. I just showed HP Fire. This gets 2-8 KO'd, I think. Okay, it doesn't get 2-8 KO'd. So T-Wave is the counter, now he misses. I think this is fine. I mean, yeah, that was lucky for me, but... What is he doing? Why did he leech it? He predicted my Landorus? That wasn't the turn to predict. Yeah, this guy played really well in my opinion. I might even get one more, because I'm... I should end it on this, because... I should end it here, because I'm not in the best, like... I'm not playing optimal, I'm just gonna get mad if I keep going as he gets a crit. Yes, Pokemon, thank you. I mean, this doesn't beat me unless he keeps critting me. Okay, Greninja comes out, so... He's probably gonna go for Dark Pulse, which if he doesn't flinch me, this doesn't beat me. As yes, he gets the flinch. Amazing Pokemon, amazing. So I'm gonna go Tapu Fini now. Which is what I should have done last turn. I'm just gonna Moonblast, I'm not gonna predict anymore. This guy is making wild plays. This is just what my problem is. Some people you can afford to play, like, they know what they're doing, right? They know what's popping. But some people just make so, like, random plays that you cannot predict them. I don't have much speed on this, so I'm just gonna Giga Drain. You can Sack a Scissor, so I'm low, which would be decent play. Moonblasting was an odd play and didn't make much sense. I guess I'm gonna try the Synthesis. Yeah, nice. We didn't face any Mega Mawats, which I was hoping, but I guess I'm too low on the ladder for that. This is the main reason I have this bulky Venusaur, but it's coming clutch versus Garchomp. It would have come in clutch versus the Rain Guy if he didn't, like, hex me out. I could have, like, beat this Marowak. I could have Giga Drain and, like, fished for Sludge Bomb Poison and Synthesis up, and he would have, like, killed himself with recoil. He was really low from Flabbergasted recoil, and the next turn, like, I would have 3 KO'd him with Sludge Bomb. I just kept synthesizing until I was healthy, and then I just click Giga or Sludge. I know it's not the best, like, Venusaur shouldn't be my Marowak counter, but I didn't think about everything when I built this team. So if I make the, you guys can make the Tapu Fini more defensive if you're worried about Marowak, but as you see, Rain is really scary, so Spedef Tapu Fini is really good for Rain and the Ash Greninja that we faced. So yeah, what could you get? I don't know what I could have done different versus the Scissor guy. Like, usually this team is not weak to Scissor, this deals with Scissor well. Yeah, you guys can make the Landorus. You guys probably should make the Landorus more bulky. Like a bulky setup Landorus. So if it's bulky, I'm pretty sure if I ran bulky. If I ran a bulky Landorus, I could have lived a plus 3 bullet punch. Yeah, I'm gonna figure out a spread. I think I have a spread. I'm gonna pause it at the end and show you guys that spread. Oh, I'm gonna put that spread in the pastebin in the description. But you guys might not want this team since I got smacked this live. So this guy's win condition is still flinching me, which he doesn't get this time. I still don't want to stay on the next one though, because I thought Giga and Oko's in for some reason. This Ninja thought, let's be bulky and live this. Yeah, Skull didn't do much. This it only came nice versus the Marowak. Somewhat came a clutch versus the Marowak. But yeah, he was running Jolly Marowak. Yeah. I've said this in earlier videos, there's so much in Sun and Moon, you cannot check everything. But in testing, this is just the version. This is what I have been facing in the 1600s. This team did pretty well versus, which was like Mega Morwell, Volcarona, Double Dance Landorus. Oh yeah, what is the rain guy? I could have just gone for Rocks with my Bronzong. As I already mentioned that. There was one misplay where I went for HPS. Yeah, he was a plus 2 Landorus, but Bronzong is like... It takes like 30 or 40 from plus 2 continental crush, so I think I could have afforded to go for rocks there. He still has Greninja around, so I'm not gonna like make any potential misplays here. I'm just wanna play it safe. Like, yeah, I'm gonna end it after this. At least we ended on a win, but yeah, somewhat painful to take L's like this. I think I took 3 L's in a row. That was a heartbreaker. So yeah, if you guys wanna help me team build, or if you think you're a good team builder or you have good teams, please hit me up. Skype, Discord, or my Facebook, on my Smogon wall, which is Dockridge. No point in preserving anything. If he kills me, he kills me. Let's say GG. And this was really long. This is gonna take like 5 hours to upload because it's HD. Yeah, I had to reinstall my recording program. There was some issue. I hope the quality is fine. So we had 1285. So we only made like 80 points progress this live. And yeah, how many games did we get? I think we won like 5 games and we lost 3, or maybe we won 6 games, not sure. I hope you guys still enjoyed. I hope I didn't get too salty. That was probably awful to watch. Check out the team in the description. Yeah, like I said, I will make the Landorus more bulky. So in case you, it probably is better. So you can set up on some things. You can take a Giga Drain from Venusaur better. But yeah, I'm not sure if I'm gonna make it HP invested or defense invested. Yeah. Smash the like button if you wanna. If you want me to keep trying, I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to peak. We are so far away from top 10. Shoutouts to Colin, he peaked 1. Check out his RMT, I might link it in the description. He's gonna shit talk me because I lost 3 games on a low ladder, and he's gonna say you're never gonna make top 10. But the thing is, which is also really hard, if I just, you would use one team that I'm really comfortable with, right? It would be like a bit easier to make top 10 in my opinion. But if I just use a different team every life, so I'm obviously not used to these teams. This team I used like 10 battles on the ladder, maybe it was on, I used this 5 battles on the ladder, I think, because this is the third or fourth version. This version I didn't even use that much. So yeah, peace out friends. I'm not sure today's Thursday if there's gonna be SPL, but I have a few more games from SPL week 6 that I'm gonna upload, Ubris and Black and White. Stay tuned for that, and I hope you all enjoyed. Thank you if you watched the entire video, and I'm out.